Samuel Barber, Second Essay for Orchestra. Samuel Barber was born in Westchester, Pennsylvania on March 9, 1910, and died in New York on January 23, 1981. His Second Essay for Orchestra of 1942 remains one of Barber's most popular orchestral works, as deserving of its fame as Barber's ubiquitous adagio for strings. Barber's essay is aptly named. Like any piece of writing entitled an essay, it is a fairly short work built on a single subject, a subject that is developed and expanded over its course until a fitting conclusion is reached. The subject of Barber's Second Essay for Orchestra is a broad and expressive theme played first by a flute and then by a bass clarinet. From there, it's off to the races. This thematic melody is lengthened and harmonized and reharmonized, played by different instrumental combinations, broken up and recombined. During one delightful episode at the midpoint of the essay, a version of the theme is used to create an energized and spiky fugue initiated by a solo clarinet. The essay concludes majestically with yet another version of the opening theme. Taken altogether, Barber's Second Essay for Orchestra is an entirely satisfying, entirely accessible work. Faire de Grofé, Grand Canyon Suite. Faire de Grofé was born in New York City on March 27th of 1892 and died in Santa Monica, California on April 3rd, 1972. Grofé was an orchestrator, arranger, composer, pianist, and violinist. Between 1920 and 1932, he was the chief arranger for the Paul Whiteman Band, one of the most popular and successful dance bands of the time. It was Paul Whiteman who commissioned George Gershwin to compose Rhapsody in Blue, and it was Grofé who arranged Gershwin's piano score for both Whiteman's band and for orchestra, the latter being the version heard most frequently to this day. If Rhapsody in Blue is Grofé's most famous arrangement, then Grand Canyon Suite is his most famous composition. Grand Canyon Suite features all the craft and slickness of a high-end film score, which is essentially what it is, a picturesque, engaging, if musically lightweight piece that is best accompanied by exactly the sort of visual imagery that will be featured during the concert. The third and central movement, entitled On the Trail, is the most famous of the suite. It's a depiction of a mule train plodding along one of the canyon's many mule trails. Charles Ives, Symphony No. 2. Charles Ives was born in Danbury, Connecticut in 1874 and died in New York City in 1954. He was a composer of genius for whom music was a hobby. Ives made his career as a respected insurance executive who commuted by train to his office in Lower Manhattan from the burbs in Connecticut where he lived. A discussion of Ives and his Second Symphony occupies the bulk of my long video program note for Classics 7. I would humbly suggest that you check it out. Suffice it for now that Ives's Second Symphony dates to 1902 and that it is a synthesis of a Brahms symphony and a collage of American folk music, patriotic music, and hymns. The symphony concludes with a spirited rendition of the American anthem, Columbia, the gem of the ocean, followed by a giant Bronx cheer by Ives' own admission, a preemptive middle finger to his critics. Fun. Thank you.